Anyway. Tongue twister. Part 4, The House at Huai. Huai? I can't really say it. Manet's painting about a house. La Maison de Huai. I really can't say that, so I apologize to all you French speakers for totally butchering that town name. You can see Manet's painting in really great detail on Google Art Projects. There's a link in the thing below. So Manet's painting is just of the facade of this house. It's beautiful, like a lot of Manet's work. It is sort of got these greens and yellows and blues that make it seem very summery and warm. There's shade, so you feel like you would be comfortable even though it might be hot out. There's this inviting little garden bench. To me, the most interesting thing about this painting is the tree that bisects the middle of the frame. And what it serves to do actually is block the front door of the house. So you see the triangle-shaped cornice piece there, and then you see what maybe looks like a door, and maybe it's even open. But the tree really obscures any chance you would have of seeing into the house. And then if you start to look at the windows, you have three windows that are dark on the side, which is sort of odd since it's daylight out. The rooms are sort of purposefully obscured. And then you have one that's completely shuttered and closed, and then the two on the other side one is entirely obscured by the foliage and the other is like whited out and sort of like almost like the reflection is keeping you from seeing what's going on in the house. And so even though you have this very inviting, you know, the garden path that circles around and leads you up to the front door, this house is cut off from you. You are cut off as a viewer. You're cut off from the house itself. So it invites you at the same time that it distances you. And, you know, I think that that is what Virginia Woolf was writing about, except from the other perspective of someone being in the house. You know, you imagine being in this house, and even if the front door is open or the windows are unshuttered, you know, you are sort of fortified inside of it, and you know that people can't really see out into your private and intimate space. And, you know, if you look again at the shot of our house, I purposefully composed that shot to look like the Manet painting, and I feel a similar thing here in our new house, that we are sort of set back from outside civilization and what's going on out there. We're sort of kept very private. We're allowed a lot of privacy in this space, and that's what houses do. I think that's why humans, you know, started to build houses that like a single family would live in rather than a whole community, because we all sort of intensely feel a need to separate ourselves from the world and to be like alone with ourselves. And I think that's a really powerful metaphor. I think that's what Virginia Woolf is writing about.